You're about to hear a story about someone named Alex. Alex represents a victim of domestic abuse who lives in West Yorkshire. The people you're about to see all know and care about Alex. This story is just one person's experience of being in an abusive relationship. In reality, Alex could be anyone you know. They could be any age, gender, ethnicity, and from any background. All of these people knew that something wasn't quite right with Alex.
We were always really close. I knew something had changed, but I didn't know what. I can't believe I didn't realise.
Alex used to always be up for a night out. I'd noticed the last couple of times they'd always bailed. I just thought they were in a new relationship and it was because they was loved up. It never occurred to me that it was because they wasn't allowed to go out.
I couldn't help but notice the bruises. There was nearly a different one every time they came in. I didn't think it was my place to say anything.
We used to do all sorts together as a family, but Alex just got really distant. I should have asked if anything was wrong.
Alex came in a few times to this salon. Every time they came in, we had different cuts or bruises. Each time, I always asked what had gone on, but they always said, fell down the stairs, walked into a wall, tripped over kids' toys. So just went along with it. I didn't really think it was my place to say anything, but deep down, I think I knew they were lying.
So I noticed whenever we met up, Alex was always checking the phone. Sam was constantly texting and would ring up if they didn't get a reply straight away.
Yeah, I just thought that Sam was being concerned, but then it seemed more like Alex was being checked upon. To be honest, I thought they were being quite rude, but I just got it so wrong.
I heard them arguing all the time, but I thought if I said anything, I would get into trouble.
Alex always seemed to be in a rush to get home, and they wouldn't hang around and talk like they used to. It was as though it wouldn't go down well at home if they were late back, but I just thought I was reading too much into it.
I went a couple of times and they were clearly arguing. It looked quite heated. But I just thought all couples argue and left it at that. Didn't do anything about it. Looking back, I wish I'd have said something. Maybe I could have helped.
I heard the shouting and the banging through the walls. It were happening more and more often. And I did ask Alex if they were okay. They made it very clear it's none of our business. Keep his nose out. I even picked up the phone to phone the police a few times. Husband told me not to get involved.
A few members of staff came to me with concerns about Alex, but I brought them in for a chat and they assured me that everything was okay. If it wasn't affecting their work, I really didn't think it was my place to say anything.
I used to lock myself in the room when the shouting got really bad. I was scared. I didn't know what to do.
We used to meet up every week, but it seemed like Alex didn't have time for me anymore. I've got the feeling that Sam didn't like me, like they were jealous of how close we were and wanted to keep them to themselves.
I noticed Alex always wore long sleeve tops, even when it were red hot. I never thought to question why. And it seemed so obvious now it was to cover up the bruises.
It was obvious something wasn't right. We were so close. We had no secrets. Alex did come to me a couple of times in the state and begged me not to say anything. Just wish I'd said something.
In West Yorkshire, we deal with approximately 140 incidents of domestic abuse every day. Domestic abuse can take the form of physical violence, but it can also involve psychological abuse such as coercive and controlling behaviour. On many occasions, once the police have become involved, it becomes clear that friends and family have had their suspicions for some time. They felt that something was wrong, but either they didn't want to interfere or didn't know who to speak to. If just one of these people spoke out when they were first became worried, then there's a much greater chance of the victim receiving help much sooner. It's understandable that some people might be reluctant to call the police for behaviour that they might not realise is actually abuse, such as telling someone how to dress or texting them all the time. But by speaking out about these behaviours, no matter how insignificant it might seem at the time, it can help to piece together the full extent of the situation. West Yorkshire Police is dedicating safeguarding officers who will deal with all reports sensitively. If you'd rather not speak to the police, there are lots of organisations who can support and give advice about any concerns that you have, and all these are listed on our website.